Welcome back in Ostrava. We're going to be watching a game, the Czech Republic against the Dutch national team. It's a quarterfinal game, so it means that who's going to win is going through the go to the final, and who's going to lose are going to play a backdoor game tomorrow against Italy. So thank you for the broadcast. The live stream is by for Technovap, Bonet, Enjoy It, Honix, Playo TV. Now let the Slavomir Novotný talk.
Thank you, Sabina Vítková, our on-field reporter, for handing over the word to me. The Czechs are one of the few teams that have participated in all eight of the previous under 16 women's European championships, while the Netherlands, for example, didn't take part 2 years ago in Norda. But whenever Team Netherlands was taking part in the cadet girls or later on under 16 women's championship, they took a podium spot. They won it twice, just like the Czechs, historically. Had a couple of silver medals and one, I'll make that two bronzes. So, as the teams are just about to get ready, you see the Czechs wearing the blue uniforms. Near some of the not so interested fans around the field, but there are crowds here that will be loud. We are used to the great fans from the Netherlands. Also, goedenavond als je ons vanuit Nederland kijkt. The fans that travel around Europe with the Dutch team, always proudly and loudly supporting their players. Along with the home team having, of course, the home field advantage with the biggest crowd of supporters in the stands. I'm sure you can hear them, so our microphones are picking that up. Home plate umpire you see over there in the middle, that's Salvatore Gondillo, helping him out. First base is Britt Nieland, and third base umpire Thomas Lonert. Here's the two-man, one-woman crew in blue. The teams are now lined up. First, we will listen to Het Wilhelmus, the national anthem of the Kingdom of the Netherlands, followed by the national anthem of the home team, the Czech Republic. semi-final game and the final broadcast of the first day of our live streams from Ostrava, Ostrava, Czech Republic, home of the 9th Under-16 Women's Softball European Championship. Here's a look at the starting defense for Team Netherlands. Now they are, of course, the visiting team because they're coming in as the seed number 2 into this game. So they'll start at offense as the Czech team is taking their field positions. You see them. See a couple of changes from the earlier game today, but most of these players we also saw participate. Participate during that game. Now, one important change to the official lineup that was made as soon as it was handed over to the umpires is that this is not number 39, Lenka Bakusová, but of course she'll be serving as the DP batting in for this young lady, Emma Vojicková, number 25. Just like all the other remaining Czech national team pitchers, she still bears that 0 earned run average. That puts the Czechs on top in the overall statistics. But the Dutch are closely behind with 1.6, facing second, while the Dutch batters have the highest average, 452, with a home run, 3 triples, and 13 doubles. The Czechs, oh, they have 2 home runs, 2 triples, and 10 doubles off the 57 hits in the 7 games prior to today. Everything about to start as the center fielder, Jackie Hypen, will lead off against this lady, Emma Vojicková. First pitch misses above for ball number 1. Here's Jackie Hypen. Second pitch taken for strike number 1. Ball and a strike on Hypen. Waited for that off-speed pitch and hits it over the head of Andrea Marquardtová, the third baseman, and will reach first base on that single into left field to lead off the game for the Oranjes. Here's Klára Čechová, center fielder for the Czech team. Runner on first, and Sophie Verdastung, the left fielder, squares up, shows early intention to sacrifice bunt. A nice dive and attempt by Andrea Marquardtová by the third base dugout, but Verdastung staying alive. Bessel Brocken, the third base coach, from whom she just received the signals. So Sophie Verdastung, the best batter in the lineup, batting at 684, a steal attempt, and the throw is in time, and the tag applied on the shoulder of Jackie Hypen for the first out of the inning. Great throw by Eliška Slaninová to Aneška Bartoňová, number 16. We saw the shortstop here walking. So just like that, the Dutch lose their runner. And Sophie Verdastung now facing the 1-1 pitch from Modičková. Laying off of that one, same patient. And she gets ahead, 2 balls and a strike. Late swing on that fastball by Vodichkova. And for Dastung now with 2 strikes. Falling slightly behind. 2-2 coming up. Strikeout for out number 2. That'll bring Bobby Schrekelhoff, the first baseman. First pitch, a strike. So Vodichkova starting very strong despite the hit single by Hyben. Strikes out for Dastung. Ball and a strike on Bobby Schrekelhoff. Time hit between the 5-6 and that hole. Team Mark Bartova and Bartonova to shallow left field. So another single into left field for the Dutch. That'll bring the shortstop to Desme. Desme batting 533 in the tournament, has a triple and 2 doubles. And leads the overall stats in runs batted in. She has 11. A pickoff attempt. Nice grab by Vesnikova at first, as that throw by Ellis Bacon was a little bit off target. Swing and a miss by Esme. And a strikeout will end the inning in the low outside corner. 2 singles, but nothing from it for the Dutch. We're scoreless midway through the first, and the home team will pick up the bats when we come back. Yeah. Here's Stere Dendijn, the starting pitcher for Team Netherlands. She has two earned runs in the three appearances in this tournament, but Team Netherlands have used up eight different pitchers throughout the tournament of the 19 players in their team roster. And a nice hit into left field where it's caught by Sophie Verdastung for a first out. Eliška Slaninová. Great shot into left field, but even better, done by Sophie Verdastung on the run. And another hit, this time into right field, where Lieke Suskind only have to play it safe towards second base to Tu Desme. And Magda Kavanova hits it between the first and second baseman. That'll bring the center fielder Chekova, pops it up. It's out of reach of Tess Remmers, who kind of ran towards home plate as Chekova was showing bunt, but then that pop-up overflew the third baseman of Team Netherlands. That misses upstairs. Ball number one. So sacrifice bunt, still a viable option for the Czech offense. But she hits it into shallow left field instead. For Dostum to Esme to stop the runners from running even further. And back-to-back singles. Load second and first base for the Czechs. Natalia Tvrzníková, number four. Lefty over to Stere Dendijn. Attempted push bunt. Tvrzníková, despite the good idea, not able to get everything going, so runners stay on second and first and two away. With Aneška Bartoňová, the shortstop, now at the plate. Taking second pitch upstairs, ball number one. Bartoňová, 313 batting average. One triple, and this time hits it into center field where Jackie Hypen won't have any trouble catching it. Each team leaves a couple on the bases, and we're still scoreless after first frame of game in this semifinal between Czech Republic and Netherlands.
Leo TV, live broadcasting.
Welcome back. Just in time for top of the second inning. Melissa Hufertz, the second baseman of Team Netherlands, batting 421 in the tournament. Lead off, she has 7 hits and 17 at-bats. Two of those extra base hits. That misses above the strike zone. And a strike for Emma Poljichkova. Poljichkova was the starting pitcher, or the one that recorded the win against Slovakia in the 15-0 win, as that one sent towards the first base dugout for strike number two. But more importantly, she was the winning pitcher in the 3-1 defeat of Italy on day three. Last night it was Anna Zolova pitched against Team Netherlands as a slow roller towards first base is picked up by Natalia Dvesnikova, steps on the bag comfortably before Melissa Hufertz. That will bring Marijn Crowell. Marijn Crowell, the catcher of the under 16 Dutch national team. Starts with a strike. Crowell is batting 400 in the tournament, which earns her sixth spot in the Dutch lineup. That only shows how a tied sixth. It shows how powerful the batters are this early. But we're used to seeing strong Dutch offense throughout all categories of this sport. Just below the kneecaps for 1-1. Home crowd really asking for that. Looking call, but Salvatore Biondillo gets in the call, and a hit towards Anishka Bartnieva, and it'll pass the Czech shortstop all the way into left center field. Marijn Crowell, another single. Make that a fielding error by shortstop. That's the official score. A short check swing by Stede Dendijn, pitcher. He's batting in seventh. It's Elike Suskind, the right fielder, who has a DP in for, is on deck now. That's Lisa Mehring. But first, Stede Dendijn, a wild pitch will move Crowell into scoring position. Stede Dendijn now facing the 1-1 pitch by Poljichkova. Outside, ball number two. A home crowd a little awakened by this important moment. As the potential go-ahead run is on second with one away. And Dallas Bacon will have a quick word with Emma Vodichkova. Three balls and a strike in the top of the second. Ball four and gets away from Slonyanova. Runners will stay on the corners. And Petr Menjak, the head coach of Czech national team, will have a quick word with his players. So will Vesel Broken. Defense is ready, marked as conference number one. Runners on the corners and one away. Strike called. Foul ball. Mehring only appeared in three games. Started all three of them. And recorded eight at-bats in them. In those eight at-bats, she managed to score a hit six times, which earns her an average of 750. And all six hits brought six runs batted in. Another foul ball. As Mehring is staying alive. Crowell on third. Then Dunn on first. Swing and a miss. A strikeout. This strong batter brings some comfort to the Czech defense. They have two away, but the Dutch still have potential to open the score of the game with Tess Remmers, the third baseman, checking her swing. Foul ball. Are an athletic family. As Tess pops it, and it's caught by Anishka Bartina on the run by the second base. Great fielding by the Czech shortstop. And the game is still scoreless. Midway through the second.
Pečeková, which is a pitching coach for the Czech national team. So did you have any special performance before this tournament?
Yeah, we try to practice from the winter, and we have small tournament before the European tournament, Prague week, softball week.
Okay, so how are the pitchers? Are they tired, or do they still have enough energy to play more and play more games?
We have quite a lot of pitchers, so we try to use all of them and to save some power for next days, because these 2 days are the most important for us.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye.
Super, super. Dobrý, děkuji moc. Dobrý?
Thank you. Sabina, our on-field reporter, as well as Mrs. Chikova, whose daughter is playing in center field this game. And she is, as Andrea Markartova strikes out, now they change up. A foul tip called, I believe. Her daughter, Clara, is one of the two Czech players with a hit in this game so far. But it's Emma Vodičková now batting for Team Czech Republic. Checks her swing. Ball bounces off the barrel. That's away in from Kralo. Hit into right center field, where Jackie Hyben makes the catch on the run. Vodičková flies out to the center fielder for the second out of the bottom of the second inning. That'll bring Alexandra Slana, number 26. And a miss by Slana, so quickly 0-2. Stetter Dundine, strong as ever. Now, Mrs. Chikova mentioned during the interview that the Czechs have many pitchers and they try to use all of them to kind of share the pain, as a single into shallow right center field will earn Slana a hit. She'll bring Lenka Bakusova. Foul ball. Ball gets away from Crowell, and Slana advances to second. Bakusová strikes out to end the inning. Two strikeouts and they fly out. So Czechs leave one runner on bases. After two innings, still scoreless. And I mentioned earlier the Ramish family But here's one of the best Czech umpires, Michal Žídek, who was also one of the umpires last week or 2 weeks ago at the Women's European Championship. And here's another interview by Sabina Vítková.
I'm here with Petra Arens, which is an executive of the European Softball Federation. And I want to ask her if she can tell us something about the new program, which is called European Softball.
Yes, well, a new program, it's a new logo. As you can see, we have it introduced this year in Bolate. And I think it was received very good. And we did it because we want to make the softball in Europe more visible and more popular. So we wanted to make a logo which connects more to the target groups we have.
And there's also something new about top six teams in Europe. There's going to be happening something more for the top six teams in Europe. So what's going to happen?
Yeah, well, besides softball in the broad range, we also want to make sure that we have a lot of good teams in Europe, which we already have, which we can see over here. And we want to make an event of it, of a top six event, where the top six best teams can play against each other. We try to make it more equal, that we have the resistance in a broad amount of teams. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Yep. You're welcome.
Thank you both, Sabina, our on-field reporter, and Petra Arens. Executive from European Softball Federation. If you want to learn more about what's happening around the fields in Europe, head over to europeansoftball.org, where you can find all the important information. In the meantime, top of the third inning, and Jackie Hyben at bat with one ball and a strike. The count. An attempted bunt by Hyben. She singled over the head of Andrea Makarova into left field. And still, for some reason, Alexandra Slana, the left fielder, is way over to close to center fielder Clara Čechová, but maybe they just want to keep all the pitches outside for Hyben in this at bat. She got caught stealing on that perfect throw by Slonjinová. And a strikeout will end her at bat in the top of the third inning. That'll bring one of the most dangerous threats for Czech defense, Sophie Ferdastonk. Very reminiscent of other strong and powerful Dutch hitters, her older role models, I'd say, like Laura Wissing or Saskia Kosterink. That wasn't called by the home plate umpire as a swing, but is called by Britt Nieland. And I believe it was a good call. It's that little movement of the wrists, like a swing. Now up the middle, Sophie Ferdastonk close single in her second at bat. That'll bring the first baseman, Bobby Šerkoho. takes the first pitch, and that misses ball number one. Sophie Ferdowsdung only has one steal attempt, a successful one. There comes the second one. This time, an unsuccessful. She's tagged out another. Dutch runner caught stealing by Eliska Slanginova. And Anushka Bartnyova, the shortstop, all smiles after another perfect tag. Here's Bobby Sherkocho. Foul ball. Just sort of wanted to swing initially. Looked like she changed her mind midway through, but couldn't lay off of that. Just enough. Two balls, two strikes on Sherkocho. This time sends it up the middle through the legs of Emma Vodichkova for another single. Brings to Desmet, the shortstop who struck out to end the first inning. Pops up over the head of Mark Artevat. It lands in the fair zone, and Sherkocho sort of wondering whether she should head for a third or second, and held up midway between these two aforementioned bases, but was nobody there really to make the play and tag her out. Here's another look, and Mark Artevat throwing towards third base to Bartnyova. Runner in scoring position, two away. And it's Melissa Hufertz. It's a bat. She grounded out to Tveresnikova in the first at bat. Ball number one, that was low. So, Sherkocho on second, Zmaj on first. And another low pitch for ball number three. Called strike on three balls. Now a great hitter's count for Hufertz, who has seven RBI in the tournament. Only struck out once prior to this game. Thank you. foul ball. That'll earn her a full count. After being very much on top 3-0, now she's facing the payoff pitch by Vodichkova. Swing and a miss. So strikeout number 2 in the tournament for Melissa Hufert. That ends the top half of the third inning. The Czechs pick up the bats when we come back. See that? The Czech supporters, just like their Dutch counterparts, are loud at this moment. The home crowd a little bit louder as their players have a chance to score that first run of the game. Up in the air, Sophie Ferdasdong on the run, won't make the catch. It gets away from her and a double to lead off the bottom of the third inning by Eliška Slaninová. Runner in scoring position and nobody out. Now that's great offer by the Dutch defense, or, well, as Slaninová doubled into left field. It's more or less not given by the Dutch defense, but earned by the Czech offense. Chose bunt. A foul ball was called by Salvatore Biondillo. Oh and two, so Kavanova, right fielder, also played a shortstop in that game against Russia. Strikes out looking. Nice pitch by Stetter Dundine. Clara Čechová, whose mom we interviewed, or namely Sabina, our on-field reporter, we interviewed earlier in this game. Signaled into left field. Huge swing and a miss by Čechová. One ball, two strikes on the Czech center fielder. The changeup misses the target. Two balls, two strikes. Yeah. And Chekova strikes out. Try to check her swing, but couldn't hold on. And Berezníková will step in. She popped up to Bobby Cherkocho. Sorry, not Bobby Cherkocho, to Sterrendine. To the pitcher. She was trying to outsmart the defense by pushing that bunt over their heads. Just didn't push it far enough. Lays off of that one, a ball and a strike on Berezníková. Hit just passed, and that will perfect throw by Sofie Furdastorn to home plate, and Slaninova is tagged out as they were trying to haul that first run in and throw down the money by Furdastorn to Crowell. I'm really anxious to see the replay of this single by Berezníková. A bullet pass to Desme.
Cleo TV, live broadcasting.
Here's Emma Vodičková, who's been successfully holding off. The Dutch batters from scoring in the third inning. We saw an interesting set of plays, probably climaxing in the bottom of the third inning with that throw from Furdastorn to Crowell. Tag out Slaninova, and it's Crowell who will lead off for calling like the Netherlands. For the Dutch team. Takes both two pitches, one of them a strike, the other a ball. A foul ball towards the third base side. Started. Well, we'll start fourth year in Mendel College High School in Harlem, Netherlands. As she strikes out. That'll bring Stede Nindine, the pitcher, walked the first time up facing Czech counterpart Vodičková. Catches the low inside corner off the strike zone. And now they go outside and get that strike called. Once again, the ball and two strikes. That's the count on Štera Mendai. Swing and a miss on the off-speed pitch by Vodičková, and Štere Dindine heads back to the dugout. Lisa Merink, designated player, who struck out her last time up. Seven strikeouts so far for Vodičková in this game. And 3 2/3. That's 7 out of 11 outs. Far has been the strikeout. Štere Dindine has only 4 so far. Slowly hit towards second base. Mariana Binková makes her first play of this game for an easy out. A 1-2-3 inning by Czech defense, and they will head back into offense. We have another interview ready for you. This time it's Marco van Eyl. We'll be interviewed by our on-field reporter, Sabina Vítková. Marco van Eyl, a 15-year-old player, also one of the Brabant Bandits, a Little League players from last year's qualification. Now interviewed by Sabina Vítková.
Okay, so I'm here with Margo van Eyl, which is a player from the Dutch national team. So how do you enjoy this tournament so far?
Really enjoying it. We're having a lot of fun on the team and we're playing pretty good games. And also now it's like a good game and we really want to win now.
So. Okay, what if you have to play the backdoor game? Do you still have the energy to play more games, or are you tired as a team?
Well, if we lose this game, that's just how it is, and then we're going to fire it up to the next game, then we're just going to make sure we play as a team like we always do, and it's not going to be like any other game, it's just going to be like we play like a good game, and we're going to do our best, and that's what we always do, and it's not like we're going to play different, we're just going to do our best, and we're going to do what we can, and our goal is to win the finals, and that's where we have to come, so that's what we do everything for.
Okay, thank you so much. Good luck.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you both, Sabina and Marco. In the meantime, in the bottom half of the fourth inning, the Czechs lead off with a hit by Bartoňová that took a weird bounce right in front of Esmantud. And hit her on the chest or on her throwing arm. Rolled all the way into the outfield where it was picked up by Alika Suskind. That prevented Bartoňová from advancing even further. Andrea Markvartova at the plate, lays off of that pitch for ball number three. So three balls and a strike for the Czech third baseman, and the Czechs have a runner on first. Nobody out. Markvartova 0 for 1, struck out once, squares up and will walk after five pitches. A single and a walk. All right. We're reaching on an error. That's the official score of that hit by Bartlinova. A fielding error and a walk. Here's the Czechs, two runners, and now over to Esmetu to throw to Demers in time to force out the lead runner. Bartlinova on third. Great execution by the Dutch defense. Here's another look and hit towards Esmetu, and Demers able to return in time. You saw Bartlinova upset as they just had hit up in the air and is caught on the run by Jackie Hyben, and the throw to third won't reach in time as Markvartova slides in. Jackie Hyben with an excellent play on defense for the Netherlands. Here's another look. Well hit by Alexandra Slana, and then the throw to third. After Markvartova tagged up, and so did Vodichkova, who's on second now. So runners in scoring position and two away, and slowly hit towards second base. Melissa Hufertz makes the throw to Sherkocho for the final out. Another two runners left on bases by the Czechs. They already have six runners left on bases. Wow. The Dutch have five. It's already a large family left on bases in this game. We will head back right after these messages.
TV live broadcasting.
Welcome back to Ostrava, Czech Republic, home of the 9th under 16 women's softball European Championship. The semifinal game underway, still anybody's game as we are scoreless after four complete innings of play. We have two more ahead of us, unless, of course, neither of the team is in the lead after complete six innings, in which case we'll head into tiebreaker extra innings. There's still a lot to go through before that happens, though. Tess Remmers will lead off for Team Netherlands. I already mentioned her mom. Traveling along with her daughter Diana Remmers. Her sister Britt Remmers plays overseas for Lakeland College. Okay. as Remmers grounds out to Mariana Binkova for the first out of the inning. From the top of the lineup, Jackie Hypen, who made that running catch going all the way to the outfield home run fence. That prevented the Czechs from taking the lead. Jackie Hyben is 1-for-2, has a single and a strikeout. One of the two Dutch runners that were caught stealing by an awesome throw by Eliška Slaninová. Strike on the inside corner. Hit up in the air into right field, and it's over the head of Kavanova. Hyben headed for third, and she'll slide in unnecessarily as it wasn't even a throw towards her. She's smiling as she's handing over that elbow guard to the third base coach, Vessel Broken, and Petra Minjak will head over to pitching circle and talk to all of his players. Now with one away and the scoreless game thus far, it's now an important moment in the game, and both coaches know that. Here they are. Talking to their players, Emma Vodičková and Eliška Slaninová, the starting battery for the Czechs. We'll have to face Sophie Fedarstunk. Struck out the first time up. Then she singled into center field, but was caught stealing. See if she can be the one to draw first blood in this game. We're still scoreless, but Dutch have Jackie Hyben on third. And one of the hottest batters in this tournament at the plate. Low and inside, Fedarstunk manages to get out of the way. Fedarstunk foul ball. Kind of bouncing around the first baseline. Great play by Fesnikova. Sort of casually picked up that ball. Just bouncing around. Sophie Fedarstunk, two balls and a strike. And a runner on third. The ball gets away, but Jackie Hyben will stay on third and won't risk it. Probably a smart call by the center fielder. Sreska Slaninová was quickly regained control of the ball. Three balls and a strike on Ferdasto. Hits it towards third base. The throw to home is in time and tag applied. They get Hyben at home plate. She's tagged out for the second time in this game. She's very upset as she heads back to the dugout, but that was a great throw by Markvartová. And no discussion there. Second out of the inning, and the Czechs able to defend. That potentially threatening situation as a foul ball will result in a first strike on Nesmatut. There's still a runner on first. It's Sophie Ferdasnung, who already was caught stealing once in this game. The ball gets away. Or not gets away because of a great block by Ashka Slaninová, but Vodichka pitches it into the dirt. It's actually not Esme Tut, but Bobby Sherkoho is at the plate right now. Lefty first baseman. The Dutch national team. She's 2 for 2. He's singling to left field and center field. Can she do it again? This time the ball gets away, but it's a ball three, and Ferdasnung advances into scoring position on second. With Cherkoho facing the 3-1 pitch by Vodichkova. Again in the dirt, this time middle. Result in a walk for Cherkoho. As Matut, who struck out the first time up but hit a single in her second plate appearance in this game. Hits it up in the air by the right field line. A nice diving attempt by Magda Kovanova, and I'm sure you can hear the applause from both sides. And it's not just Dutch or the Czech supporters here at the Arrows Baseball and Softball Park. Here's another look at that attempt by Kovanova. Good hustle by the right fielder of the Czech team. And the first strike on Esmatut. Low and inside. Ball number one. Down in the dirt, blocked by Slaninová. Another great block. And Ferdasnung will have to retreat back to second. Yeah. set of pitches in the dirt by Vodichkova, but great catching performance by Slaninova that prevents the runners from trotting around the bases. Now hit slowly towards the shortstop. Bartonyeva, the throw, takes Tvezníková off the bag. So the Dutch load the bases with two away. And that brings Melissa Hufertz, the second baseman, to the plate. Here's Fadastunk, left fielder on third. And a smile by Vodichkova, so still in the good mood. Here's another look, and Vesnikova, after that off-target throw by Bartonyeva, having to leave the bag to catch that ball. Melissa Hufertz. Oh for two in this game. And the Dutch are on the board. They take the two-run lead after the Czech defense sort of stopped playing once Mariana Binková had some trouble feeling that ball and on the error. For Dastan crossed home plate, but while Binková was trying to run around the second and tag out Esmet Toot, Bobby Sherkocho also made her way towards home plate for the second run. So the Dutch now have a two-run lead, 2-0. They have runners on second and first. That's Toot on second and Hufert on first. And a pitching change in the Czech lineup will bring Klára Pospěchová, number 88, to the pitching circle. Her older sister, Lucy Pospěchová, also used to play for the same club, Jodrispra. And now the third base umpire, Tomas Lonert, trying to explain to the Dutch offense that only one player can be warming up an offense in the on-deck circle. It's just for safety reasons, so that everyone who's walking around the field, and there are many many individuals at the moment on the field who won't be there as soon as the game resumes, make sure that they don't get hurt. Marijn Krauwel, the catcher, reached on an error and struck out, so he's 0 for 2 in this game as well. Will be the first batter of the Dutch lineup to face Klára Pospěchová. Two away, runners on second and first. And Slaninová continues with that great catching performance. That catches the inside corner for strike number one on Crowell. Popped up shallow left field, and it's caught by Alexander Aslana to end this half inning. The Dutch are on the board. They take the lead 2-0, and it's up to the Czechs to respond when we come back in the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the fifth, the catcher Eliška Slaninová is 1-for-2 with a double. We'll lead off for the Czechs and face this young lady, Štěra Dendaň. Hit in the 5-6 hole for a leadoff single, which will bring the tying run to the plate for the Czechs. Magdalena Ivanova, the right fielder. Up to the plate. She has a single and a strikeout. Kamanova getting ready for her at bat. As Lisan Spoor, the 16-year-old pitcher, will replace Štěra Dendaň. Son Spoor appeared in 4 games in the tournament, which is the highest number of all pitchers in the Dutch roster. She has pitched in the biggest number of innings as well, which is 10, and averages a strikeout per inning. Only walked one of the 36 batters she's faced. Here are Team Germany players. We already know they are in fourth place after they lost to Italy earlier today. As Kravanova no fear swings out of the first pitch by Spoor. It lands in the foul territory by the left field line. double play. As that soft liner off of Kovanova's bat was called by Lisanne Spohr, who quickly turned around and threw the ball to Bobby Cherkocho to double up Eliška Slaninová. So just like that, with just one swing of the bat, the Czechs lose their runner. And Klára Čechová is next up with a ball and a strike on her count already. Like that, a ball and two strikes after Lisanne Spohr, the lefty pitcher. Single into right field by Klára Čechová. So she's 2 for 3 tonight. This time she goes into the opposite field, just out of reach of Cherkocho and Hulfertz. Natália Tvrzníková takes the first pitch. Low for ball number one. Hits it towards the second baseman, Hulfertz, who has an easy time tossing it to Cherkocho for out number three. Not the easiest of innings. They lost their pitcher to a single by Slaninová, but managed to come back with a double play. So sort of a 1-2-3 inning, because only three batters of the Czech lineup showed up in this bottom of the fifth. Last inning coming up, the Dutch will first have a chance to extend their lead. And when we come back, we will have...
Leo TV, live broadcasting.
Welcome back to Ostrava. Final game of the day is the semi-final between the Czech, so far undefeated team, which could change in the next moments, as they are trailing by 2 runs to the Dutch. They beat them 2-0 last night, but so far we're unable to generate anything other than 7 hits. And we keep coming up short with no runs. All the Dutch needed 6 hits for 2 runs. But also 3 Czech errors, as opposed to only 1 on the Dutch side, could make the difference. Stede Nendijn, who is now serving only as an offensive player only, as she was replaced by Lisanne Spohr. In the pitching circle in the bottom of the fifth. Now at the plate, the 2 balls and a strike. She He walked and struck out in this game. Now has a chance. Foul ball for the second strike of this at bat. And she was facing Clara Fospikova for the first time. An off-speed pitch. That misses just above the zone. Ball four. And Dendine reaches first on balls. Lisa Mehring, the designated player. And I'm sorry, Sarah Dendine is now the offensive player only. She's playing shortstop. Mehring struck out and then grounded out to the second baseman Binkova in her second appearance. Has a chance for a do-over. Up to this point, she had been batting 750 in the tournament. Squares up and lays off of another pitch by Pospekova for second ball of this at bat. Squares up once again, pops it up, and it's caught by Andrea Marquardtová, the third baseman. For the first out, the top of the sixth. Here's another look. That pop-up, it's caught by Marquardtová, and set it and done. Able to avoid that double as this wild pitch gets away from Slonjinova, and Stadadundan will make it to second base anyway. So it's sort of like if Mehring was able to lay down that bunt. 0-2 in this game. Grounded out to Binkova as well. And previously flied out to shortstop Bartonova. In the first inning. So in the top of the second inning. Outside corner for strike number one. Two balls and a strike on the Nemes. Here's Pospekova with the 2-1 delivery. The foul ball. And Slonjinova a little shaken up. On the face mask, but seems all right. Hit up in the air. right field. Caught by Kamenova, and Dundine tags up and advances to third as Remmers heads into the dugout. So Kamenova makes the catch. Great base running by Dundine to take advantage of that. Good throw by Kamenova as well, make it a close play at third. So third run for the Dutch is 60 feet away, and they have two out with Jackie Hyben, the center fielder, at the plate. She is one of the main reasons why the team is still ahead 2-0, because I'm sure with that running catch towards the fence, she's saved at least one run from scoring. Now has a chance to bring another runner in for her team. She hit a single and a triple, but was tagged out twice. Once when she was caught stealing, and the other time that play at home plate. That check swing will result in a strike. One ball and two strikes, that's the count on Jackie Hyben. And she leaves it over the plate. Just caught her looking. Pospíchová retires the side. The Dutch don't add any more runs, but it's up to the Czechs to score at least two in the bottom of the sixth to maintain their undefeated status and keep their hopes up alive for a win in this game. When we come back, bottom half of the last inning is coming up. The shortstop, Anežka Bartuňová, is the first batter off the Czech lineup to start against Lisanna Spor in the bottom of the sixth inning. Now, if you're just joining us, the Under-16 Championship is played all throughout for six innings only. The only difference in the playoffs is that we have no more time limitation, like we did in the round robins. Line into right foul territory. In the air, and it will land in front of Ferdowstrom for a single. So Bartuňová delivers in the bottom of the sixth and reaches first base as the leadoff batter for the Czechs, which will bring the third baseman Mark Vartová, who walked and struck out. Also time for her to score a hit. She now represents the tying run for the Czechs. Well, apart from the first game between France and Ukraine, all three other games are very tight and thrilling, nail-biting, and interesting all the way till the end, which is always great about the last 2 days, as Marco Artova will walk and Lisanne Spohr puts the tying run on base with that walk. And now, with nobody away, the Dutch will have to have a quick word with their third base coach, Wessel Brocken, coming over to talk. It's Ilya Hartvine talking to his team. Probably reminding them that it's the runner on first that they have to keep from crossing home plate. Strike number one on Emma Vodičková. Now she was the starting pitcher for the Czechs in this game and hits it up the middle. It's caught by Den Dijn at shortstop and a nice little shovel to Esme Toot for the force out of Mark Vartova at second. Runners on the corners with one away and the tying run is still on base. It's Vodičková now on first. And Ilya Hartvine will probably make some changes. We're awaiting the official word on that. And as soon as we know, we'll let you know. So Kelly Bessems leaves the game. So Kelly Bessems enters the game to replace Crowell. That's the catcher. So Lisanne Spohr now facing Alexandra Slana, pops it up in the air, it'll be caught by Tess Remmers. And the Czechs are down to their last out, and the Dutch are only one out away from making it into the final. Another delay as the Dutch team will make another change. And so will the Czech team. They have a pinch hitter setting up by the plate. It's Anna Dušková. She appeared in 4 games and has a batting average 429. And she will face a different pitcher once again. It's Jill Clue. So two players who still haven't been in this game so far will be the final actors. And it's a slow roll towards second base. And the Dutch have made it into the final. The Czechs find their first. Find themselves losing the first game in this tournament. And it's the Dutch who have secured themselves at least a silver medal on tomorrow's grand final. So what's up next for us? That's it for today, of course. Tomorrow we'll start with the backdoor semifinal game between Czech Republic and Italy, 10:30. So set your alarms early if you're watching us from somewhere in the Western Hemisphere. That'll be very early for you. Later on at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, Slovakia against Belgium for the ninth place. And then 4 o'clock, winner of Czech Republic against Italy, the back door, will face the Kingdom of Netherlands in the grand final. On behalf of all the crew here at Playo TV and everybody responsible for our broadcast, thank you for tuning in. That's it for today. We'll see you tomorrow at 10:30 for the backdoor semi between Czech Republic and Italy. Thank you for joining us. Have a good night.
Playo TV, live broadcasting.